Hello and welcome to Cisco Small Business Video on Demand. I'm going to demonstrate how to set up multiple VLANs on an RV320 router. The RV320 and the RV325 are easy to configure, offering you security, growth, and collaboration to your business. After you have logged into the router, click on Port Management, and then click on VLAN Membership. For this demonstration, I'm going to create three VLANs and assign them each to their own port. For this demonstration, I'm going to add VLAN 4, 5, and 6. VLAN 4 will be for sales, and I'll add VLAN 5 for accounting. And last, I'll add VLAN 6 for shipping. Next, I'll click Save, and now I can edit the VLANs and assign them to specific LAN ports. Each LAN port can only have one untagged VLAN. By default, VLAN 1 is always untagged. First, I'm going to disable device management on the new VLANs. Next, I want to assign VLAN 4 to LAN 2. I'm going to exclude VLAN 1 and exclude the guest VLAN and leave the voice VLAN tagged and untag VLAN 4. Next, I want to assign VLAN 5 to LAN 3. I will exclude VLAN 1 and exclude the guest VLAN. I'll leave voice VLAN tagged, exclude VLAN 4, and then untag VLAN 5, and exclude VLAN 6. And last, I need to assign VLAN 6 to LAN 4. I'm going to exclude VLAN 1, exclude the guest VLAN, leave the voice VLAN tagged, exclude VLAN 4, exclude VLAN 5, and make VLAN 6 untagged. This will allow each group to have their own separate network. I'm going to save my settings and then click on DHCP. Under the VLAN ID, I'm going to choose VLAN 4. If you wish to use a different IP address, you can change it here. For this demonstration, I'm going to use the default. And for the DNS server, I'm going to use DNS from ISP. After you click Save, you'll be prompted with a warning about changing your IP address. Click Yes. Next, I'm going to select VLAN 5, and I'm going to keep the default settings except for the DNS. And I'll click Save, and then I'll be prompted again, and I'll click Yes. Then I'll select VLAN 6. And I'll follow the same steps as VLAN 4 and 5. If you have a phone system that's voice over IP, select VLAN 100. Here you can set up the subnet for your voice over IP system. For this demonstration, I'm going to assign VLAN 100 10.1.1.1. Next, click on Range Start, and it will automatically fill in your DHCP scope for that subnet. Then choose your preferred DNS server. Then under the TFTP server configuration file name, enter the host name and the IP address of the TFTP server. You may also enter a configuration file name used to update the device. If you do not have a host name or configuration file name, you may leave that section blank. Next, I want to enable inter-VLAN routing for VLAN 4 and VLAN 5. This will allow sales and accounting to communicate with each other. Click on Port Management and then click on VLAN Membership. First, I need to enable device management for VLAN 4. After I save my settings, I'm going to connect my PC to a switch that's connected to LAN 2. I have connected my PC to VLAN 4 and obtained an IP address. I was able to log into the configuration utility on 192.168.4.1. Now I'm going to verify my IP address and test connectivity to VLAN 5. I am able to ping VLAN 5 over the router, but I will not be able to ping the PC that is on VLAN 5. To enable the inter-VLAN routing for those two VLANs, click on Port Management, and then click on VLAN Membership. Then check VLAN 4, and check VLAN 5, and then click Edit. Next, I'll enable inter-VLAN routing for VLAN 4 and VLAN 5, and then click Save. Now I should be able to ping the PC on VLAN 5. That concludes this demonstration of VLAN configuration of the RV320 and 325 routers. Here's a list of more Cisco small business devices that may also suit your business needs. For more information, go to www.cisco.com. Or if you need technical support, please call 1-866-606-1866. Thank you for choosing Cisco for small business, and I'd like to thank you for watching.